here for homecoming.
Amen.
Miss Diane Bird. She's gone home. She's in a better place. She's alive today. We've got to believe that. She's made it home. And you know the God that we serve, He says He don't look at the outside and judge us for what we do. He looks at our hearts. And Diane Bird had a heart of gold. She was loved by everybody, most of her family. And let's pray for these families. She raised two fine girls, a fine boy, four grand young'uns, and she loved them dearly. But Brother Pete is suffering the greatest loss. He's lost a part of himself. Married to her 50 years. It's going to be hard for him. But if we'll do one thing and pray the shortest prayer in the Bible, Lord, help me. He will help you. I am living proof of that. And a lot of others, you know, He will help us. He'll never leave us or forsake us or forgive us. And Sister Diane is in a better place. She'll never hurt no more. She'll never suffer no more. She'll never cry no more. She's in heavenly places. It's in a place that the Bible says one glimpse of it is worth everything we give up down here to go there. And Charles Stanley said something in his big church the other day, and a bunch of people. He said, how many of you is going to die? Every one of you. That's the only way to get to heaven. We have to pass out of these bodies. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we're gathered here before you today. We know you're here with us, Heavenly Father. And Lord, we pray for this family, Lord, that you attach every heart here and help them with what they're grieving, that they've lost. But we know earth is lost, is heaven's gain, and we know she's up there with you today. With the grace of God, she's gone home, and the memories that she left, and the fruit that she left here, Heavenly Father. She's with her mother today, having a good time, Heavenly Father. And Lord, we believe that and stand on that today in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen and amen.
Rain. So go rest high.
You know, Sister Diane was a woman of all things. She enjoyed life down here. She enjoyed fishing. She enjoyed her place at the beach when she was able to go, but she got to where she wasn't able. Last time I talked with her, she said, I've not been able in 2 years, not able to do the things I used to do. But she loved her family. She cherished her family. She loved her grandchildren. She raised all four of them in that store. And imagine that now, and had to teach them what they could have and what they couldn't have. Now, she'd put her foot down, but she raised them because she loved them till they got ready to go to school. And she was just that kind of woman. She was strict, but she was good. She was loving. Everybody that come to that store loved her. I've never heard nobody say nothing bad against Diane. And let me tell you, she had good times down here, but she's having better times down where she's at in heaven. And you know, the Bible said that David asked God about his boy. And God told him, said, David, you can't bring him back, but you can prepare to go be with him for eternity. We've got that right. We can prepare to go be with Diane and her mother and our loved ones forever and ever. And I'm going to tell you, read to you right here where she's at. 14th chapter of John. It says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. That's Jesus Christ. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, rooms, or what you may call them. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also forever. That's a promise of God to everybody, every man, every woman. Right there. And I believe that's where she's at today. He got her place prepared. There's two things we don't know. We don't know when, and we don't know how. But we do know it will happen. Someday, it has to happen to all of us. No flesh will go to heaven. We have to die from these bodies and go in a spiritual body, in a brand new body. A body to never be sick and never hurt tomorrow. I know there's a lot of burden in this family. It's going to take it hard. But listen, you don't be married to a woman 50 years and lose her. The Bible says when a man and woman gets married, they become as one flesh. And there's a part of that's gone for Pete. And I pray for Pete. Because it's going to be hard on him. But with God's help, nothing is impossible. We can do it. So if we just have to put it all in his hands. I am nothing without him. And I'm everything with him. We don't have, we come in this world with nothing. The Bible says we leave with nothing. But I rephrase that a little. We come in this world as a sinner. But we've not got to leave as a sinner. We can leave as a saint, praise God. And that is the gospel, that we can go to heaven. Not because you're rich, not because you're pretty or ugly. He said, ever who shall call upon the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved, and his name written in the Lamb's book of life. We've got that guarantee. And I'm so thankful that one day he called me. Is that song a while ago? I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. I lost two brothers and preached both of their funerals. I didn't think I could ever do it. But God said, you can do all things through me. And I love this family. I've learned that this family is my family. And Diane would always call me if anything sick. When she had cancer, I'd drop down there, pray for her. God is a healing God. God is a saving God. God will do it all if we will just turn it over to him and listen to him. Heavenly Father, I pray again that you just touch this family, Lord, and open their hearts up that they can see the goodness of God and come in and dwell inside of them. We know you're not going to force yourself on nobody. You say you stand at the door and knock. If they're open, you'll come in and fellowship with them and show them a better life in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
This whole world is full of sinners, but just a few are chosen to tear your heart out when they sing. Imagine life without them. All your radio heroes, like the outlaw that walks through Jesse's dreams. No, there'll never be another red-headed stranger, a man in black and Folsom prison blue. The Okie from Muskogee, or hello, darling. Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes.
Who's gonna fill their shoes? Who's gonna stand that tall?
Who's gonna play the Opry and the Wabash Cannonball?
Who's gonna give their heart and soul to get to me and you? Lord, I wonder
who's gonna fill their shoes.
God bless the boys from Memphis, blue suede shoes and Elvis. Much too soon he left this world in tears. They tore up the 50s, old Jerry Lee and Charlie. And Gold Cat Gold still echoes through the years. You know the heart of country music still beats in Luke the Drifter. You can tell it when he sang I Saw the Light. Old Marty, Hank and Lefty, why I can feel them right here with me on this silver eagle rolling through the night.
Who's gonna fill their shoes? Who's gonna stand that tall?
Who's gonna play the opera and the Wabash
Cannonball?
Who's gonna give their heart and soul to get to me and you? Lord, I wonder
who's gonna fill their shoes?
Yes, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear. We have
praise God, that says it all right there. That's the way. And you know how I know where Sister Diane's at? The Bible says absent from the body is present with the Lord. She's with the Lord. She's not here. And talking about heavy shoes to fill. There's some heavy ones left. But she raised two girls and a boy. And she raised them to fill her shoes. And carry on her dream. I know Pete's down and out. But listen, y'all can do it with God's help. Don't never give up on God. God said there's nothing impossible for him to do. Nothing he can't do. And Philly, Virginia, you can do anything. Amen. Praise God. And I love y'all. And anything I do, y'all just call me. Heavenly Father, Lord, we pray for this family. We know where she's at. And we know we're going one day, Lord. And Father, just help us with the grace of God, Father, to be ready to go, that her name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and that we will be with you one day for eternity. Bless this family, Lord, and lift them up for what they've got to go through with. In the wonderful name of Jesus, we humbly pray. Amen and amen.
I surveyed all the good things that come to me from above. If I count all the blessings from the storehouse of love, I'd simply ask for a favor of him beyond mortal king. And I'm sure that he'd grant.
Praise God. I know many of you don't know me, but the Bird family do know me because it was my family as well. And I long to look, ask God to give me the strength to get up in the morning times on my way to work here in Benson. Stop by every morning. When I walk in the door, I would say hallelujah, because that is the highest praise to God. Hallelujah. Amen. And as I said to the family, if God didn't heal her or deliver, it wasn't because he couldn't. It was just that he chose to call her on home to beautify the garden in heaven. Because she beautified our church and her flowers and her bows and stuff. And every year I look forward to her making bows and flowers for our assembly building. So I'm going to miss those blessed hands as well as her. And I called her mama as well because my mama's name was Diane. And I love this family. They are a good family. And they treated me with love and respect, and I respect them and love them as well. And I ask God to continue to strengthen Mr. Pete, Tina, and Scott, and the rest of the family. And I know that God is able to do it. So y'all just continue to live with the love that she so give and gave to many as you enter into that store. Carmen and Madison, bless their heart. I will walk in and they be running around the store. But just know that Granny's still with you. She's gone on, but she's still in your heart, and she lives. So continue to live and enjoy life. Because it said to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So I'm looking for that great day when I'm called on. And I hope that I will see her there so she's making flowers or bows or whatever. We'll praise God together. Amen? Amen. So God bless you all under the sound of my voice. And may heaven smile upon you.
Folks, the family greatly appreciates your attendance today, your acts of kindness that you've been by the home, brought food, or come to the funeral home this morning. We're going to escort the family and a chair for Mr. Pete over to the vehicles, and you're welcome to go over and speak to them there. Have a blessed afternoon.